Hello everyone, today we'll be covering how to use groups and instances in FormIt. For this we'll use the Create Primitives Cube or Alt-B to demonstrate, and we'll begin by copying the cube by either using Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V, or once you have the object selected, simply press Ctrl, select a point to copy from, and you'll see a preview of the object and you can click again to place it. If we edit one cube, nothing is happening to the other because they are not identical instances of a group. Let's begin by double-clicking to select the whole cube and right-clicking to activate the context menu and select the Create Group icon or use the keyboard shortcut G. Now if we copy this group a few times, we are creating identical instances of the group. So now when you double-click to edit, you'll see the other instances responding exactly the same as we select a face and drag the face. Even if one of the groups is rotated or on a different level, if it is an instance of a group, it will update based on any changes made to any of the other instances. This is why, when selecting options in the array properties, you have the choice of grouping the solids together, then arraying. So if we were to try to make a fence or a linear array, you're able to edit any instance to manipulate the entire array of solids. Grouping is an important part of modeling in FormIt. As your model becomes more complex, you will develop many groups with identical instances, so at times you may want to select or locate all of the instances of one group. If you hover over a group and press the Tab key, this will highlight every instance in the current editing context. Groups can also be made unique from each other and nested within each other, which is explained in the Make Unique and Nested Groups video. And that's it for FormIt groups and instances. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.